third century. He said he was a bishop. I forget where, but without making guesses. He says, take your left hand, put your right hand on top of it, making a throne for the king, and approach the presbyter, or approach the priest or the bishop, and receive the king of all in your hands. This is the same way the clergy partake of the Eucharist today. And consume the body of Christ, then go to the deacon and drink from the chalice.
Separately.
It wasn't until later on in the development of the divine liturgy, and I'm talking, oh gee, 11th, 12th century. See, that whole span of time. It wasn't until the 11th or 12th century that the two elements of the Eucharist were combined, and the faithful started to receive communion with a spoon. It was for practical reasons.
Okay.
For practical reasons. Because what was happening? Sometimes pagans would sneak into the church communities and steal Christ. They'd come up for communion and take him away and go desecrate the body of Christ.
Hmm.
Yes. Or steal the Eucharistic bread for some type of pagan ritual. So both of the elements were placed together into the one chalice. And the priest began to distribute firstly with tongs, then it moved to a spoon. Tongs, why? Because in the book of Isaiah,
the hot
tongs, taking the coals from the holy altar and placing it on Isaiah's lips. The priest says the same words after the distribution of Holy Communion. Behold, that which has touched your lips and cleansed you of all your sins. That's from the book of Isaiah. Because what do we receive when we receive the Eucharist? Christ's divine body and his divine blood. A coal that burns away the sins of mankind. The sacrifice, the one eternal sacrifice from the one eternal high priest that remits the entire sins of the universe. Okay, any other questions? Anything else? Okay, well, we'll conclude for the week. Thank you everybody that is tuning in to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching, and we'll pick up with the same topic next week. Same time, same channel. Thank you. Have a good evening, or good night, or good morning if you're watching it in the morning.